kid that you won't date. Why was I born too late? Born too late to have a chance to win your love. Oh why was it my fate?
The worst thing somebody can say to a kid is, enjoy being younger, you'll miss it when you're older. When you say that to someone who's young, you're just proving to them that life doesn't get any better. It's like going up to a teenager and saying, this is it, it's the best it gets, have fun, good luck. Probably not the best thing to say to an emotionally unstable person who already doesn't know what to do with their life. And when you don't know what to do, you just get depressed because you feel like you're wasting your life away laying in bed watching TikToks. Older people don't really do much to prove that life objectively gets better. So when you admit your best days are behind you, what's the point of going any further? Now, all of a sudden, you feel like you have to savor every single moment of this supposed golden age. It's important not to allow yourself to be attached to anything too much. And I say that because when you decide to attach yourself to a passion project or something that you enjoy doing too much, you mistake your identity for that thing. And when you don't enjoy that thing, or when you stop pursuing it, you start to hate yourself. And that's how I think a lot of people end up with identity crises so early in their lives. Because for the longest time, they pursue one thing, and that's okay. But they pursue that one thing so hard that they say, without this, I am nothing. Without this, I am incomplete. I am blank. And when they do that, and then that thing goes away, what are you left with? Where are you going then? I don't think it's possible to attach yourself so closely without it being an unhealthy relationship with that passion project. as humans are programmed to desire fitting in, no matter what it is, we want to feel like we're a part of something. It's why you donate to charities. It's why you join sports and clubs, and it's why you play the same video games and watch the same TV shows as your friends. Yeah, you might actually like Squid Games for the plot, but you know you watched it because everybody else was. And that's fine. It can start to get discouraging when all you see is people who are better than you. We see the point of success of all of these people, that we expect to achieve whatever they achieve overnight. And when we don't, it feels impossible. The internet can be tricky like that. Don't let someone else's day 50 compare to your day one. In this day and age, we're surrounded by deception. You know, everything we look at through screens is filtered. It's what we want to see, and it's what other people want us to see. But beware of the jungle that you have entered, for the biggest threats come in the form of deception. I don't know why I like coming here so much. It just makes me feel like really comfortable, really relaxed to be like higher up than everything and be able to see my environment. I really like where I live. You know, kind of in the middle of nowhere of Pennsylvania. I think it's a perfect balance between isolation, but also being close enough to do things. I think if I had a choice to spend my childhood in a certain type of environment, I wouldn't change the one I actually grew up in. The word environment includes more than just this location, though. It includes the school I went to, the friends I made, the family that I had, and how close they were. I'd never forget how lucky and privileged I am to have all those things, have all those good things in my life. But it's just sometimes hard to remember that you have those things once you get so set into a certain place. You know, I've lived here pretty much all my life, and I'm definitely ready for a change, but I know that when that change comes, I can't guarantee everything that I once had. You can't cross the ocean until you're not afraid to lose sight of the shore. You know, you have to be able to take at least one giant leap of faith and know the consequences that could come out of it. But the problem is, humans, people, were built to be stuck in their ways. We were meant to share ideas and pass down knowledge that we have to future generations. So when we live in a world that moves so much quicker, that evolves so much quicker than we can comprehend it, then yeah, no wonder people are gonna prefer their where they live. They're gonna prefer the cartoons they grew up with. They're gonna prefer the music that they listen to. That's just how it is. So this world, as fast moving as it is, nobody is able to keep up with it, no matter how hard you try. And that part kind of frustrates me, you know? Like, I hate knowing that I'm never gonna know everything. And I hate knowing that there's so much more out there that I'm never going to be able to experience that fully exists as a very real thing in other people's lives. I can try as hard as I can, you know. I'm not just going to sit on my ass and do nothing about it, but I will fail. Yep. I will fail. This is Kyle. We're on Logan.
Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice message system. At the tone, please record your message. When you have finished recording, you may hang up or press 1 for more options.
I thought about you today. Not for a long time, but long enough that I felt like I should reach out, you know? I know nothing's new with you. You know, I would know if there was. It's just nice to want you every once in a while. Do you think about us? Do you miss the you that was with me? This was dumb. I'm sorry.
The original intent of this video was for the majority of it to be scripted, because I wanted to get important content across in a structured manner, because the message that I wanted the viewers to receive was important. I felt like it was something that they really had to grasp, and if they didn't, then they would leave this video feeling empty. But as I kept reviewing my script, and as I kept thinking about how much of a hypocrite I am to give filtered content that is disingenuine almost, it just felt wrong. This world lacks so much authenticity that I feel the need to provide it with a certain amount. I think the most important thing that I've learned this summer is that life is a series of distractions meant to make you forget about all of the periods of time within your day-to-day life that you want to forget about. The things that you want to forget about could be anything. It could be your shitty job. It could be a breakup. It could be family problems. It could be stress towards school or sports. Or it could be nothing. Because I know there are days that I wasn't necessarily sad or mad or depressed, but that I still just wanted to forget about. The hardest part about trying to empathize
is that it is impossible for anyone to understand how another person thinks. Because no matter how hard you try to put yourself in their shoes, at the end of the day, they are wired differently. They feel differently. They experience differently. They engage with the same things you engage with differently. And there's nothing you can do about it. Life is hard. And to a certain point, you have to fight. And to a certain point, you have to push back. I'm just really, really tired.
The sunburned hands.